Hello students, welcome back to my class. In today's class, I'll teach you health and physical education. And this class is meant for class 10. The topic of today's class is Mission Indradhanush. So let's start. After independence, one of the major problems faced by Government of India is high rate of child mortality. Due to various vulnerable diseases, many children died before they attained their first birthday, before they celebrate their first birthday. To stop or to minimize the child mortality rate, various measures were taken at that time, and immunization program being one of such measures. Immunization program in India was introduced in 1978 as expanded program of immunization, in short it is known as EPI, by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India. In 1985, the program was modified as Universal Immunization Program, in short UIP. Now, Universal Immunization Program to be implemented in phased manner to cover all districts in the country by 1989-90, with the one of largest health program in the world. Despite being operational for many years, UIP has been able to fully immunize only 65% children in the first year of their life. Through UIP, Government of India is providing vaccination free of cost against vaccine preventable diseases, including diphtheria, pertussis, tetanus, polio, measles, severe form of childhood tuberculosis, hepatitis B, meningitis, pneumonia, Japanese encephalitis, etc. To strengthen and re-energize the program and achieve full immunization coverage for all children and pregnant women at a rapid pace, the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, Government of India, launched Mission Indradhanush in December 25, 2014. Mission Indradhanush, it is a health mission aimed at achieving full immunization coverage against childhood diseases for all children. Now next, let's see why Mission Indradhanush named thus. Mission Indradhanush depicts the seven colors of the rainbow. In the beginning, the mission aimed at the immunization of all children against seven preventable diseases. The diseases being targeted are diphtheria, pertussis, tetanus, childhood tuberculosis, polio or poliomyelitis, hepatitis B, and measles. In addition to these, vaccines for Japanese encephalitis and hemophilus influenzae type B are also being provided in selected states. In 2016, four new additions have been made, namely rubella, Japanese encephalitis, injectable polio vaccine, bivalent, and rotavirus. In 2017, pneumonia was added to the mission by incorporating pneumococcal conjugate vaccine under universal immunization program. Okay, now next, why Mission Indradhanush is a critical for our health system? In a nation that is always waging a war against childhood death and disability, immunization is one of the most cost-effective public health interventions against it. As I told you earlier, in 1985, the Government of India launched Universal Immunization Program to ensure that every child gets full immunization against all the preventable childhood diseases. It was one of the largest health program of its kind in the world. But, however, over the next 30 years, the program was able to fully immunized only 65% children in the first year of their life, which I explained in the first part. It was with the aim to strengthen the existing program that Mission Indradhanush was launched. Full immunization prevents the large scale of outbreak of diseases. It also keeps this disease under control in an area. Now, if India is successful in carrying out this childhood immunization program, it would help to reduce the child mortality rate to a great extent. And this will definitely help India to progress on socio-economic indicators. Now next, let us see what are the goals of Mission Indradhanush. The mission was launched with the focus on interventions to expand full coverage in India from 65% in 2014 to at least 90% children in the next 5 years. The government aim to do this through special catchy campaigns. It was decided that painstaking planning, public mobilization, efforts and intensive training for health workers would be conducted primarily in high-risk areas identified by the polio eradication program and areas with low routine immunization coverage. In the first phase, that is April to July 2015, 200 high focus districts across the country were targeted. Next, impact of Mission Indradhanush. As we have discussed earlier, Mission Indradhanush aims to increase full immunization coverage in India to at least 90% children by 2020. Till June 2016, the mission has covered 195.5 lakh children and 51.1 lakh pregnant women. It has covered 497 districts across 35 states and union territories. By 2017, a total of 528 districts have been covered under Mission Indradhanush during various phases. In October 2017, the Government of India launched Intensified Mission Indradhanush, in short IMI, in selected districts and urban areas of the country with an aim to achieve the target of more than 90% coverage in immunization. The primary focus groups of Intensified Mission Indradhanush program are the children up to 2 years of age and pregnant women who have missed out on routine immunization. However, should there be any request of vaccination of any child up to 5 years, it would be provided during Intensified Mission Indradhanush rounds. As of today, Mission Indradhanush and related programs have successfully reached out to and vaccinated 3.39 crore children and 87.2 lakh pregnant women in India. So, that's all for today. In my next class, I'll come with another topics. Till then, keep learning whatever I explained and enjoy your days. Bye.